Hello students, today we are going to see about paint. So yes, you can see the screen over here that is related to paint, and you know very well that you will go to start and in that programs you will get paint. You can also search it by the search box, as you can write it over here paint. You will write it and you will get it over here the paint. Okay, so let us start. You are already knowing about the components. Let us see quickly. What is over here? That is the paint and the title bar, in that minimize, maximize, close. This is a restore button. You will also see over there the file tab, home and view. Okay, with that you can see over here the slider bar for minimizing or maximizing the screen of it. Okay, so here you can see that I make it very small over here. Yes, we can turn it again to 100. And you can see over here that in the home tab you are having many of the tabs and the groups. The groups are clipboard, image, tool, shape, size, colors. Okay, so let us start. So first of all we are going to see about the shapes. Yes, you know this all things. This is pencil tool. Yes, by the pencil what you can do, you can write it, even you can change the size of it and it will be written in that way. Okay, next we are having over here the fill color. Yes, you can fill the color over there. Next is the text tool, right? So that is to write the text. Okay, if you want to write the text. Okay, next now we are having eraser. Yes, when you have drawn anything you have drawn it over here, then yes, you want to erase it, you can go by the eraser. Okay, so it will be erased over there. Okay, next after that we are having pick color, by which we can pick the colors, that I will explain you afterwards. And this is a magnifier, so if anything wrong is there in that we can see. So let us start. So first of all, you know about this line tool. In that we are having different line sizes. As I have told you, there are different sizes by which you can draw the line. First of all, you select the color. By default it is black, so we will go with the black. If you will press the shift key, then it will draw a straight line. So just see over here. Okay, sorry. Next, now we can see over here the curve tool, like a curve tool in which it will draw the curves. Like I have drawn this way, I want to give a wavy lines. Yes, I can give the wavy lines on both the sides. That is also possible. Next is the oval tool, or you can say the round tool. Yes, we can use the oval tool. I am drawing an oval. Please keep it in mind how you have to draw it. You have to keep it at the starting and till the end point where you want it. If you press the shift key, then it will draw a perfect circle. Otherwise it will turn to an oval. Okay, if you want a circle then. So as you have selected the thickness, now you want to go with different colors. Yes, you can go with different colors also. Okay, I have kept it selected, so the color was changed. Okay, now I will go with different color. I will take another color over here, and yes, again the same thing you will follow, right? And even you can move it, that thing. Yes, you can move it, you can adjust it. If you want to adjust, you can adjust that thing. Okay, like I have adjusted. Next, now after that we are having the color picker tool. Yes, color picker tool. Like here I will first of all fill the color. Like I want yellow color, I will fill this yellow color, and then I will fill it. That same color I want it in the another area also, or I will take another shape, right? Another shape I will take it. I have taken another shape, and in that also I want that same color. What I will do, I will go with the pick color, color picker tool. Please keep in mind, color picker tool. What it will do, it will pick the color, and that same color will be given in another shape also. So yes, we will pick the color. I have picked the color, and now I will go with fill. Yes, you can see over here. Let us see again. I'm going with another shape. You can see here the color is changed. Okay, and I'm taking another shape. Okay, now what I will do? I will go with the another one more shape over here. Okay, done. Now what we are going to do? We are going to select the color. Like I've selected the color, fill it. Now that same color I wanted. See, I've turned it to black, this thing. So you can see now how you will use it. So click on color picker, select the color. You can see as I've selected the color, it is turning to a fill tool. Okay. So as many times you can fill it. Okay. So this is about the color picker tool. It will copy the color. Means what it will do? It will copy the color from one object to another. Next, now we are going to see that is select tool. Okay. So select tool, what does it do? Here we are having many options in that rectangular selection tool. As I will click on rectangular selection tool, it will do the selection in the rectangular way, or you can say the square. And then I can move it anywhere, or I can just cut and copy or paste it. I can copy it and paste it, Control C and Control V. Okay, so this is about it. Next, we are having in the select tool. This is for the selection, free form selection tool. Okay, here I have selected the area. You can see it will be done in the rectangular form only, but it will be in the free way, right? So that much area you will select and it will be done. Okay, so yes, I can move it that much part. Okay, next, now we are having moving an object. Now how you will move an object? You will select that object. I have shown you at the first only rectangular selection. Now I am doing the selection of this. As I have done the selection, now I can move it anywhere I want to. Even I can increase or decrease the size of that shape which I have kept it selected. Okay. So what you can do for moving, we are having the two ways over here. That is the shortcut key and also cut paste. Okay. You can see in the clipboard the option of cut. Click on cut and you can go to the new file. Yes, you save this file. You save this file and then now I'm on the new title, that is I will paste it. So Control V, or you can go by the paste. You can go by paste also. Next, we are having copying an object. Now how you will copy that object? So yes, we will open the file which we are already we were working. Okay, here I will give it title 3. Yes, I'm back to my the first file which I have created. Now copying a file, please remember, copy a object and cut an object is different. Copying an object means it will make a duplicate copy. Okay, and cut means what? It will move that object from one place to another. Yes, we will do that thing. First, let me take it out this thing. Yes, now we will go with this. Yes, I am selecting. Okay, now I'll go with copy and then paste it. You can see here there are now two objects. Okay, because I have done copying. Copying means a duplicate copy of an object. Okay, now I will cut. Okay, so I'll click on cut. Okay, I will click on this also to cut. I've cut. Now paste it. So it is being pasted. Okay, and you can move it as you wish. Next, after that, we are having different shapes over here that also we can draw. like you have seen about the rectangle. Now this is rounded rectangle. Why it is called rounded rectangle? Because in that the sides are, the corners, the edges are all in the circle form. You can see that part. Okay, next is the polygon tool. Polygon tool is useful to make a triangular way. You just see that I have taken one place. Now just click on the ending where I want to move it. So yes, I have formed a triangle. You can go with another things also, like okay, I want to make a star. I am making a star with that. So this is also possible with the triangle. Okay, now the next is simple triangle. This simple triangle also you can draw it. If you want to fill the color, then you can fill the color. You can see here the solid colors, you can use it. Then you are having crayon colors. Okay, I don't want any of it. I just want the solid color. Yes, I will go with solid color. Next is to flip. Yes, for that we have to take another object. I will take it over here, one car I will draw over here. One car, or you can draw a house also. I'm just drawing over here the house. Okay. Then let's just, now we will do one change over here in the color so you can understand that how we are doing the flipping. Okay, we will select. Okay, here we will go with another one here. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to rotate this thing. So rotate, for that we have the option over here for rotation. So yes, you will select again. The main thing is that you have to do the selection. So yes, I will do the selection. We will first fill the color, so that will be also easy for us. Yes, I will fill the color. Okay, done. Now select it by the rectangular selection. As you will do the selection, now you will go for rotate. You can see rotate right on the 90 degree, it will be done. Rotate left, so it will come back on its original place. Okay, we are also having rotate 180, so it will go opposite of it. And again, then it will come back to its original place. So this is about the rotation. Yes, flipping the picture. Now the next is to resize or skew the picture. Okay, so how you will do that thing? So first of all, as I have told you, first you will select it. Now we are having resize option. As you will click on resize, one dialog box will be open in which it is given percentage and pixels. Okay, your percentage and pixels, you can see that horizontally the area will be big or vertically the area will be big. So here I am giving horizontally first. Okay, so you can see over here it is turning big. Okay, it is turning big over here. Now again I will do the selection. First I have to do the selection, so I will select it. I have selected. Now I will go for resize and I will go vertically. Vertically I can make it small also. So yes, vertically it is becoming small. Okay, Then we have skew option in the degrees, right? So skew means what? It will. This was for the stretch and stretching, right? Stretching. You can say to how to stretch that thing. Expected ratios on that it will do. Okay, I will not do unexpected. I will just go with. You just see both the things I have done. Yes, it is stretched from here also and from here also, horizontally and vertically. Okay, now I want to decrease it. Whether I can decrease that thing? Yes, I can decrease that thing. So I will go to resize and I will change it to 50, and here I will just remove it, maintain expected ratio. Okay, and done. Okay, so this is about it. So we have resized that thing. Now we will go with the next, that is skewing. So select the area and then you will click on skew, that is in resize. Okay, in skew there is in degrees. Okay, so please see that thing, that it is in degrees. So we will go with degrees. Here we will write 50 degree and here 80 degree. Okay, I'm just giving for the horizontal first. Okay, what happened? Horizontally it is moved on that side. Okay, now I am going vertically. So again resize. Yes, I have to select it, that area, and then click on resize. I will go with, you can see here it is given horizontally means it will go this way like this, and vertically means it will be stretched up. Okay, so this is about it. Okay, now the next is text tool. Yes, text tool, in that you want to write something, that this is what, this is an house. So you can give the color for that. Okay, you can give the color and you can write. You can also go with the text size and that all. Yes, you will see here the text. I'm selecting the text font. I'm going with the size of it. Okay, bold, italic, whatever you want to give. Created by me. Okay, this way I'm writing. So that is also done. So this way you can insert a text. Even if you want to write a story, a picture, you want to keep it and you want to write a story, yes, you can do with it. Next is about opaque and transparent. Yes, opaque and transparent, everyone know. Transparent means what? So let us start. First of all, we will go with the thing which you want to take it. Okay, I will go with the text first. In the text, select the area, and now you can see that what you wanted, opaque or transparent. Okay, so yes, I want with the opaque, and with that the color. Yes, in that I will do the selection of the color. Color 2 also I will select it, and color 1 also I will select it. Okay, and then I will write, you can see here, this is about opaque. Okay, so yes, we have gone through the opaque, in which I have changed the color, background color of that text area, and also the foreground color. So what is this color 1? Color 1 is about the colors, that is the foreground color, and color 2 is for the background. You can see here foreground and background. Okay, so next, now transparent, that we have already done. Transparent we have already done it. Now zooming the picture. So zooming the picture, you will click on this magnifier, right? And as you will click on it, you can get it over here. Okay, so zoom in, zoom out, you can do it. Even in the view, you have the option of zoom in and zoom out. Zoom in, zoom out. Okay, so this is also possible. You will go to home tab and again you will click on magnifier, so you will remove that thing. Next is setting a drawing as a desktop background. How you will take it this as a background, okay, for the desktop. So here you have the option of set as a background, desktop background. You must save the file before choosing. So I will save it my file. Yes, I have done the changes. Now we are going to save it. So yes, we will click on save option. We have done it. Now we will go for set as background. Okay, so now you can see that my background is changed. Okay, now the next thing, that is creating a new drawing. If you want to go for the new drawing, then you can go for file that I have already done, file new. So the blank paint drawing area will come over there. Okay, if you want to save it, you are having the option of save. So you can save your file wherever you want to save it. You have to select the location where you want it. Okay, and lastly, if you want to open your drawing which you have already saved it, then you will click on open. Okay, and you will select it the file. If you are not getting, you can go to the option here which you have already kept it, means recently you have saved it, so that you can click and open it. Hope you all have understand about this thing. Thank you.